Previously on Persona 4 Arena.
Well, you're done.
And now, back to the tournament.
Hello, hello, hello!
It's LOI Games, back with some more Persona 4 Arena. Where we last left off, we were asked a really serious question. What if we had to kill each other? Let's find out what our response is. Kill each other. I truly hadn't anticipated that question. I'm caught off guard by how I hadn't even considered it. It's true, there's no guarantee that this General Teddy won't suddenly decide to make us fight to the death on a whim.
Sorry, that was probably over the line. I don't know why I said that.
I wouldn't let it happen.
Even if I was forced into such a situation, I would never follow that order. That's all I can say right now. But after hearing my answer, Miss President cast her eyes down again. After seeing that behavior, felt a sense of incongruities. How could that be? Something doesn't feel like her. Could Miss President be carrying some unimaginable burden that she has yet to confine within us? Is it so heavy that she would ask that question to me? Speaking of which, General Teddy does not turn out to be her shadow. What does this mean? What does that mean about whatever repressed thoughts she truly has? Suddenly, it seems like her courageous and cheerful demeanor are a minor image of that, and a slight sense of fear chills my spine. My thoughts race down my head while we walk down the hallway.
Oh! What are you doing?
I thought I broke my nose for a moment. It's an invisible wall again? God, these things are so annoying. Just let me walk through, please. I have her permission, don't I? Even though I should have expected them, I relaxed my guard and walked right into one. I hold my nose and wave away Miss President, who looks concerned.
There's an invisible wall. I don't think I can go through here.
Yeah.
An invisible wall? Oh, that must have been why you broke out of the mime act every now and then.
The mime act?
Well, if I can pass through, it must only be blocking the tournament fights.
Apparently so.
This world sure is out there.
And you're right about that. Miss President walks through the place I had bumped into. So that must be the case. As I'd imagine, Miss President is unaffected by these walls. Is it because she's not one of the fighters in the Grand Prix? Of course, if General Teddy really is her shadow, maybe the normal rule doesn't apply to her. The entrance leads into the school building. Leads to the school building is ahead of us. But perhaps, worst of all, that the wall I had just walked into blocked me from reaching there. I just have to find some other way. No, there are walls there too. And the same can be said for the direction towards the entrance. A thought crosses my mind as I check back the way I came. It's as I thought. Another invisible worm has formed where I had just passed, and I can't go back. With walls in every direction, there's nowhere I can go. I'm trapped. And if I can't go anywhere, that can only mean one thing.
This probably means...
Yeah, it probably does. The moment I call out to Miss President, General Teddy appears on the monitor in the entryway. It means my third round of the P1 Grand Prix is about to begin.
Is your snout okay, Sensei? Jeez, you're such a klutz!
Shut up, Teddy.
You're still using that form? It's a getting old. Why don't you just show your true self?
Come on already.
Boy, you got peevish. I don't have any idea what you're talking about.
I was intentionally trying to rile him up, but he wasn't falling for it. It looks like I'm going to get him to reveal anything. It looks like I'm not going to get him to reveal anything that way. I quickly changed tactics.
So who's my next opponent?
Ooh, now you're getting into the spirit of things. Let me guess, you're starting to enjoy beating up your friends?
As if. Who's the next challenger? General Teddy doesn't pick up on my intention and loudly yells out what appears to be his pre-battle catchphrase. Smoke pours out, and who should appear from the smoke but the person I was expecting to see? Four of us entered the TV together. I've already fought against Yosuke and Yukiko. Then.
That's what I thought. You're the last of us, after all.
Yeah, seems so. Isn't that right, Chie?
Yeah, I had a feeling you'd be next, too.
Chie laughs along with me. For a moment, there doesn't seem to be anything wrong with her words and actions, but I can't let my guard down around her. After all, I felt the same way when I encouraged Yukiko too. But, as they say, third time's the charm. I have to see if Chie is in her right mind. I decided that the best way to do that is to be calm and start a conversation with her.
Chie, you know what they're doing, right?
Before I can begin to explain, Chie cuts me off.
I know. The stuff we say gets twisted around so we end up fighting each other, right?
Huh, so you probably are in your right mind.
Don't worry. You're the son of a bitch who left us as soon as the last case ended, but you're still our good friend.
Left you?
You have it easy. You're just fighting your friends.
What?
You had to kill me over and over, all because of you humans!
Now that's not Chie. Now this is obvious. Chie is clearly not herself. It's so blatant, Her words don't offend me at all. Moreover, it's not just out of character, but Chie would never say anything like that. And you humans, that's as good as confessing that you're not human. Carnivores, was it? Miss President was watching us from nearby. She looked more dumbfounded than worried. Still. Move my camera. What Chie said at the end caught my attention. I had to keep killing, over and over.
More stuff about killing, huh? This president was talking about it earlier, too. This must be.
Yeah, you think about it too, don't you, Yu? Wait a minute. She's not even trying to sound like Chie anymore. I can't even begin to understand what she's talking about. But, if a shadow is intentionally making people say these things, what does this mean about Miss President? Killing each other? All because of humans? What kind of secret past could the new student council president of Yasogami High School be harboring? No, now's not the time for this. I'll have to look into that after we cleared up this confusion between
us.
I ignore her words and draw my sword. Immediately, Risei's voice echoes through the area, as if she was waiting for this. What? Slight advantage.
Will you, Senpai? I'll talk
and no skill managed to eke out a win this time?
What do you mean by no skill? Did you see me in those previous fights?
Let's get this show on the road. Ready?
Shut up and let's just finish this. Yes, place a bookmark. Right there. Right before this fight too. Wow, I'm only like 10 minutes in. That's pretty darn good. Alright, I got to a fight. I'm gonna take this in. I need to find out what his favorite part is. I need to find that out. Alright, let's get this show on the road. Well, that ended that fight. Yeah, of course it's over. I'm the champion, of course. Even though I didn't finish it epic as I wanted to, it was still a good fight. Save, please. Thank you very much. I've won. I lower my sword and begin slowing my breathing. I don't believe I've injured Tia too badly. Considering this was my third time having to do this, I feel like I'm getting pretty good at not having to seriously wound people in a fight.
Wipe that smug look off your face. This isn't fun at all.
Why not? It's fun to me, seeing that face of yours all in the frown. General Teddy has seen that fight. The fight's ended without any injuries and spits his words through the monitor. Goodbye. The image on the monitor then disappears without anything further. Let him say whatever he wants. I fought all the friends I came into the TV with, and none of them are hurt. All that's left is to head to the announcement room and make sure Narukami is safe, and then we'll be able to go home. I walk over to Chie to help her off the ground. She's come back to her senses, and she seems a little sheepish. Are you alright? Man, you are no challenge at all. Man, you are no challenge at all. Are you alright? You know, I'm gonna be funny and say you are no challenge at all.
Hey, that's me. Man, you are strong though. I'm kind of shocked at how much of a difference there is between us.
Yeah. Look who's talking. I've never been kicked around so badly in my life. I wait for Chie to reach her feet and then tell her everything that's happened up to this point.
So the others are safe too? Oh, what a relief. I was pretty worried.
No need to worry, Chie. Chie's so relieved that she sits down on the floor once more. I can't help but smile at that reaction. She really does care about her friends. Oh, look, he's smiling too. That's awesome. Yeah, these are the people I believe in. Seeing us exchanging smiles like nothing was wrong, Miss President sounds perplexed when she speaks up.
You guys really are tight, aren't you? Makes me jealous.
Jealous? Why jealous?
Well, we did spend a whole lot of time together last year because of that cake.
Not just that, but also, we might spend a lot of time with Chie in another series I might be doing. The Persona series. Of course, I was thinking of doing Persona 4 Golden, but I don't have a PS Vita. And, yeah. So, Persona 4 is just going to have to do. So, don't say hello to any of the other social links in that, or say hello to other people in there. Because we won't be seeing much of them.
Sure, I was surprised to hear such weird stuff coming from him, but I know he'd never say any of that to me.
Of course. We're tight. We're close.
Wait a sec. Who are you?
Oh, yeah. Oh, I forgot about that. I quickly introduce Miss President and tell Chia that she may be the victim of this case. But Chia looks again at Miss President suspiciously.
Huh? The student council president? You mean ours? That doesn't seem right. I remember the new president being a guy.
Huh? New president being a guy?
What are you saying? I'm the student council president. Who else would I be?
Chia, are you sure you're not mixed up?
Pretty sure, though.
So, the student council president is supposed to be a guy?
Maybe if you told me your name, I'd remember.
Oh, yeah, that's right. We never even got her name. We will find out her name now.
My name?
Miss President stops moving. You're Miss President? What's going on? She can't tell us her name? That's not that strange of a question, is it? Well, for some reason, Miss President seems unable to answer. I sense some kind of melancholy from her. She and I share a tense glance.
My name's...
Miss President?
What's wrong?
Yeah, what's the matter? Did you forget your name or something?
No, I don't want to fight anymore. Why do we have to kill one another?
Wait, kill? You're not making any sense. Kill one another. I guess when I hear those words fall from her mouth, I don't know what's crossing her mind right now, but she's definitely not acting normally. I glance at Chie, then try to approach Miss President in the hopes of calming her down. Ow. Without warning, Miss President began flailing her arms as if trying to ward off demons. Then only she can see. Chia reaches out and touches her in concern. Miss President's arm catches Chia and easily knocks her aside. Chia, are you okay? What power? It knocked me to the floor.
Ooh, that knocked me to the floor.
I barely managed to catch Chia before she slammed into the concrete wall. Still, this breakdown, when the world happened to Miss President? Once I've helped Chia back on her feet, we carefully approach her from both sides. This will be a little rough, but it can't be helped. We can't ask her anything while she's like this, but at that moment...
What?
Wait, what just happened?
No way.
Before I knew it, Miss President was flying through the air. She was jumping? For a moment, I can't comprehend what I'm seeing. That's no ordinary leap.
Panty shot.
She was at a standstill, but now her entire body was suddenly up higher than my head. Her jumping ability is unbelievable. She and I look up in astonishment as Miss President kicks off the ceiling and changes directions and lands on at a full run.
Wow. Who is that girl?
Chia, are you jealous now?
Did I say something to offend her? She did mention something about her memories.
I don't think you said anything to offend her. But if my suspicions is correct...
Memories did seem a little muddled. Maybe she was on the verge of getting them back.
Yeah. This place. Could this place possibly be what she's thinking about?
What kind of memory would make her go nuts and run away like that?
Something that she doesn't want to remember. Something real painful. And I know you guys out there have those memories too. Memories that you don't want to remember, humiliating. You probably did something bad and you don't want to remember it. I can't answer Chia at all. What if you had to kill one another? I heard Miss President's sad voice in my head. Tia apparently wasn't expecting me to answer, and she continues.
I'll wait here. Make sure you rescue her, okay?
Yeah. Her voice is strong and confident. To drive the point home, she pokes my chest with a finger as an order, as if ordering me. Oh, I thought it was like a seductive point. Because like she had like that smile. Even though she might be in danger herself, she's still worrying about others. All of my friends are like that. That makes me feel really happy right now. I ask Chia if she'll be alright on her own. She fires back. Let me worry about that. I nod to her and begin to running after Miss President once more. I will save her. No matter what. Huh? Are you serious? Man, what a bore. I'm gonna run out of breath at the end of this. Even though I was running as fast as I can, the invisible walls kept preventing me from making much headway. I attempted to strike at the walls with my persona, but nothing happened.
So many invisible walls, one after another. Miss President can pass through them. I don't know if I can keep up the pursuit.
Yeah, it will be quite difficult. The announcement room is still my destination. There's no way to know if that's where Miss President is headed as well. But if there is a shadow waiting for me there, I'll need to get there anyway. Teddy and Risa should be in the announcement room. And if Nanako is being held captive, that's where she'd be as well. I have to keep running, but yet another wall blocks the hallway. At first, I think it's the dead end. I realize I can cut through a classroom and come out the other side of the wall. It's forcing me to enter the room rather than let me go straight. This probably means I brace myself for putting my hand on the door. The moment I stepped inside, a familiar voice echoes in my mind.
Hi. Senpai! Can you hear me? Please answer me!
Huh?
That voice.
Is that you, Risa?
The real one?
Real one? Is that really Risa? Her voice isn't coming from the PA system. I'm actually hearing it in my head. This has to be the work of Risa's own persona.
Thank goodness. I've been all alone since that weird fake Teddy captured me. And then you were all fighting each other.
You saw that? I can hear the relief in her voice. She sounds so different from the insensitive and rude voice that has been coming from the PA system. This is indeed the Risa I know.
Where are you now, Risa? Can you locate where I am?
I'm sorry, I don't think there's time. I'm stuck in the announcement room. Please, Senpai, you have to hurry. If you don't, he'll...
Risa?
Risa! What's wrong, Risa?
There's no answer. The communication has been cut off. Has something happened in the announcement room? My heart begins racing. The enemy made us fight each other as participants in this tournament, but they had also captured Risa as well. It's clear to me that they must have been worried about her using her persona powers to tell us the truth, but that's not important right now. If she was just captured to prevent her from communicating with us, then the enemy must think of Risa as being less valuable than those who had to fight. She sounded okay. But who knows what might have happened to her now. I have to hurry.
Pardon me for interrupting while you are lost in thought.
Why does that voice sound familiar? A hand brushes to my shoulder. In surprise, I jump away and draw my sword. I can't believe that I let myself get lost in thought. That I didn't notice someone until they touched me. I do that a lot. That happens to me a lot. This is the second time I've let myself get distracted. I've gotten used to having my friends with me while investigating last year. I can't pay attention to the entire world on my own. I need to brace myself. It is, isn't it? Yep. I look up, seeing another unfamiliar face. A girl with blonde hair and striking blue eyes. Wait, A girl? Her face and voice seem human. Like, but the rest of her... There's metal everywhere, all over her body. For a moment, I wonder if it's just an elaborate costume. But I can see the interior framework of her body, where her joints connect.
I didn't mean to startle you.
No, no problem.
You're,
It's nice to meet you. My name is Aegis. And no, I am not human.
Nice to meet you, Aegis. I remember you from the previous Persona game. Persona 3.
You are the one from the introduction video, listed as the Sister Complex Kingpin of Steel, Narukami-san, correct?
Yes, I am the master of all personas. I am the Sister Complex Kingpin of Steel, you Narukami!
The question catches me off guard. I wasn't expecting a complete stranger to call me that. And did she say she wasn't human? Well, when Yosuke called me by that stupid title, I knew it was a joke. But when a stranger says it, it sounds like they truly believe it. This is a pain.
Nanako is important to me. Calling it a complex is stretching things.
Yeah, she is important, and I don't know if I would go that far. No, wait a second. I was trying to play it off, but in the end, I blurted out Nanako's name anyway. Calm down. I need to take this conversation away from the subject. I clear my throat and try to start over.
Aegis-san, was it? Why are you here?
Our primary objective is the destruction of shadows, but we have come to this world on a different mission.
A different mission?
The destruction of shadows?
Do you happen to be part of a group that started with K? She fights shadows, but how can she do that if...
Does that mean...
Yes, I have a persona as well. Though my body is a machine, personas are the strength of the heart after all.
That is true. Just as I thought. I'm surprised to find another persona user outside of my group of friends, and a robot on top of that. I can't come to grips with all of this. From the way we were talking, she seems like a normal person, only in an interesting suit. True, I've seen stories on the news about robots looking uncannily like humans, but isn't something like this far beyond those? Still, I can't help but believe the evidence of my own eyes. I mean, I've been hopping in and out of the TV the past year. Who am I to say what's strange or not? Perhaps the technology behind her creator, has supernatural roots of its own. I find myself growing more and more interested in how she came to be here. We'll have to put that aside for now. There's something I need to find out from her first. This pre-1 Grand Prix, it's so similar to the events of last year, but to think that it would involve someone like her. I don't have a clear picture of anything. This happens, that's happening. That's for sure. I call myself, then ask her what I feel I would tell me. I feel would tell me what she's doing in this world.
What is this mission of yours?
She opens her mouth to respond, but just then... The monitor inside the classroom turns on. I need to find... Oh. It has the name brand. It's at that moment I suddenly remember. It's like I'm going to have to fight here. I've forgotten about sensing that when I entered the room. Shut up.
Ooh, who's the honey? You in the middle of trying to score with her?
Maybe not. And it doesn't have anything to do with you.
As if you didn't know. You're the one who lured us both here.
Truth.
Oh my, did you figure it out? I didn't have a choice after those guys decided on their own to hoard in on the fun. You're a bright boy, Sensei. You know what's coming next, don't you?
Yes, I know. There's no need to remind me. General Teddy on the monitor gives me a twisted smile. Could Agus-san's mission be something that would cause him trouble? I can't figure out what his motives are, but he's using us to crush each other. In other words, she's the next challenger that being set against me. Agus-san seems to understand this as well, and starts and staring at the monitor with a quiet...
Sorry about this. Do you know the rule of this tournament?
We have to fight each other.
Only the victor of each match may move on. Yes?
Yes, that is correct.
I have nothing against you, but I'm in a hurry for my own reasons.
Same.
Neither of us, in other words, can back down. Then there should be no hard feelings.
And I don't want you to hold back either. Agus-san is refreshingly straightforward about this. She immediately takes a fighting stance. A bitter thought comes to me. It's tough being forced to fight my friends, but for some reason having to hurt someone that I don't even know is tougher. Even another thought comes to me, the heel of that one. I don't know this girl. Perhaps her appearance here means that she has urgent problems that an ordinary student like me can't fathom. What gives me the right to stop her on her mission? Shouldn't I know what's at stake before I take that from her? Thankfully, it seems like she hasn't gone mad like the others. Perhaps the enemy doesn't care about clouding the minds of people who don't know each other. If we're still capable of understanding each other, then we should talk this over before we do anything.
That will not do. We will speak more of this after one of us wins.
Oh my god, she's a mind reader! Agus-san says this so quickly, as if she was reading my mind. For a moment, I'm struck by how she could have known what I was thinking, but I realize that she's right. What good would it do for us to talk things over? True, the loser cannot leave this room, but until we have a battle, neither of us is going anywhere. It doesn't really matter if we can come to an understanding or not. Until we have our fight, none of our goals are going to be accomplished. If that's the case, then it's better if we don't hear about each other's problems before we fight. That could be why Agus-san hasn't told me anything. This must be her version of kindness. I silently ready my sword. Agus-san appears to smile slightly when I do. Right. I'm not going to give up on what I'm fighting for either. I need Nanako and my friends to be safe. And I have to make sure that Miss President is okay. I will use everything I can to protect them. To thank her for her consideration, I make a point to announce that I'm ready to start the fight.
Here it goes. No need to hold back.
Let's fight at full strength.
Indeed. Let us do battle.
Sound like a robot too. Will I be able to save or... Yes. Okay guys, I think I'll end it here for now. Anyway, like and favorite if you enjoyed.